does not mean every single time that you're gonna do every single workout, every single run perfectly because you're tough. Like, that doesn't happen, right? What actually makes you tough are the runs that sometimes kick your butt.
Opened your door to the man with the long coat and the long list of victims. Everybody watching knows he's the one keeping the score. Where she sits, everyone stands in judgment. People watching as the curtain falls down.
Tell me your name.
My name is Joe Cameron Blake Walters. Everyone calls me Blake. My parents had me in like baseball, soccer, hockey. I did a lot of sports because they wanted to try and fit me in some I enjoyed, and so they put me in a lot of these regiments, and I really appreciate that, but none of them really clicked for me. What really clicked for me was NPE. The warm-up lap. That was my favorite thing to do because I, you know, back then it was easy as being the fastest kid, all the girls would like you. So I was like, if I'm the fastest dude here, I'm gonna have all the ladies. It didn't work out like that, but that's what first got me into trying to be athletic.
So the early lesson in life is chicks dig runners.
Yeah, I guess so.
Growing up, I mainly played soccer. I ran here and there, but it was just all soccer. That's all I wanted to do. I wanted to play college soccer. I decided to do cross country after my sophomore year of track. I decided that I wasn't going to play soccer anymore. So I figured might as well go all in on running because I was doing pretty well that sophomore track season. Usually get there 5:45 in the morning. Very, very fun. That's always the deal breaker for people is if they want to wake up for the morning. So once you get there, you've done the hard part.
In the morning when I wake and the sun is coming through, oh, you fill my lungs with sweetness and you fill my
go. So it'll be a minute 30, 1 minute rest, 2 minutes, 1 minute rest, then back down the ladder, 1 minute and 30 seconds, minute rest, and then you have 30 seconds, and that's going to be obviously faster. The 30 second rep should be one that you're like, you know, you're feeling the burn a little bit.
Can I take it to a moment?
I'll go up to the front at 30 seconds.
And the trees are filled with memories. But the feelings never told. When the evening pulls the sun down. And the day is almost done. Oh, the whole world is sleeping. But my world is
I got these rappers all breaking up a sweat. Cause every time I get up on the mic, I come correct. And I learned it from the best. Always dressing something fresh. Looking for a little dime, big
suitcases.
Yes, they heard I used to rock, yes. But now I'm rocking clothes that ain't in the stores yet. Travel back in time, I'm in a vortex. Time make it work out, think I need more vets. Used to take a bus, now the boy for jets.
And then Coach Tink was like, you're on the team. So it was to get better at soccer, and then I ended up liking cross country more. I did not handle the morning practices well at all. The morning practices were probably the hardest part at the beginning of like starting it all, and so was the running. I did not really like it.
Yo, Chuck, what's the move, man? I was on my way up here to the studio, you know what I'm saying? And this brother stopped me and asked me, yo, what's up with that brother, Chuck?
Quick, good job to those that were here on time. Thank you very much. We leave, we're supposed to leave at 5:30. So I can't say I'm super thrilled with this morning and how it all went. But we're going to get better, so I think that's going to be okay.
Well, yo, right now, kick the bass for them brothers and let them know
what goes on. Rolling stones of the rap game, not bragging. Look bigger than Jagger, not sagging. This brother backwards, I'm going to leave it at that. Daddy got nothing to do with rap. Check the facts, expose those cats. Who pose as heroes, take advantage of blacks. Your government's gangsters, so cut the crap. A war going on, so where y'all at? I'm like that doll, Chucky, baby. Keep coming back to live, love life like I'm crazy. Keep it moving, rising to the top. Duck fresh, clean living, you don't stop. Revolution means change, don't look at me strange. So I can't repeat what other rappers be saying. If you don't stand for something, you fall for anything. Harder than you think is a beautiful thing. Get up!
I grew up running with my dad quite regularly when I, back in my old neighborhood even, so before I was 8, we'd run a mile, or I remember my longest run before it was like 5 miles, that was when I was like 9 or 10. Still waiting to fall in love with running, I'll say that. I more or less remember it was something I could do. Like, oh, maybe I could stick through this, maybe around my third season, where I was the tiebreaker, that one race broke 19. I'm like, oh, maybe I can stick with this, and maybe something will happen.
So, you're in like with running, maybe? That's the right term?
Yeah, maybe we're in the friend zone as of now.
I was by running outside the parking lot like a maniac while he was talking to my dad. So that was it. The team was much smaller than we have now. We have got like, what, 31 kids now? I would say we had less than 10 before. Like, I was on the varsity team when I first joined, and that's 7 people.
All of my life. the fast tracks. We have soccer courses.
The gravel.
Yes, the gravel, right here. Yep. Use it to your advantage.
Get yourself up to where you guys want to be. You're looking around where you're at with this competition.
I know, right?
Let's go, Francisco! Come on! Give me your stuff, people!
Southwest Florida Christian. In second place, with a score of 83 points, we have Southwest Florida Christian.
Estero, that's always the meet where our JV guys come in. Last year they won it. I'm pretty sure they won it this year again. Or they got second, my bad. Didn't mean to disrespect all of them. But they always come out and show up really well at that race with the hill. They definitely conquered it.
Heavenly Father, thank you for this morning. Thank you for the opportunity to be here and to be able to run. Pray that you'd give each and every athlete just the allotted amount of strength they need today. I pray that you would be with them as they are warming up, doing the workout, cooling down. Be with them physically. I'm going to hold this one. We are watching the two groups that we're in charge of, but we are not necessarily timing them outright. This is where you're going to start, right here at the green cone. You're going to start here every time. Follow the cones. I tried to make it a little bit more rounded if possible. Today, jumping off the porch like mom's not home. Tell me why the best things feel so wrong. Summer nights, love them how they take so long. Run with the feeling of being alive while we're jumping off the porch like mom's not home. Just a couple kids living on our own. Summer nights, love them how they take so long. Run with the feeling of being alive while we're still young. I leave worries behind, sun in my eyes, summer breeze lay on my skin.
How many is this group?
That's how we build on these memories we share. That's how we build
on these memories. Nice, good job, guys. Good job.
Let's see.
Okay, so we'll go this way now. That's how we build on these memories we
share.
Okay.
I got all three.
There he is. Oh,
there you go, Patrick! Jumping off the porch like mom's not home. Tell me why the best things feel so wrong. Summer nights, love them how they take so long. Run with the feeling of being alive while we're jumping off the porch like mom's not home. Just a couple kids living on our own. Summer nights, love them how they take so long. Run with the feeling.
So I would say, like, running at Lakeland was definitely, like, those trips and those runs definitely made me fall in love with the team and running.
All right, so that took about three seasons for you to, quote unquote, fall in love with running. What kept you coming back up until that point?
I honestly do not know what kept me coming back. I don't even know. Because looking back at, like, how I ran, like, my first couple years, I was like, ooh, that was bad. I think I just, like, something was just kind of keeping me going, whether it was 1 year. Because I remember, like, after the year, like, each season, I was like, oh, I'm not going to do it again. It's a lot. It's, like, stressful and stuff. But I still showed up. So I kind of just went with it. And then I got to see, like, obviously where God was taking me with it, because I'm glad he kept me in it.
The most obvious way that running has affected other areas in my life is just the discipline it instills of just going there every morning, running as hard as it gets, not quitting, and just keep fighting mostly. It applies in academics when the courses get tough. It applies in pretty much almost everything in life, with relationships and everything, that, you know, just the discipline it instills is priceless.
I joined the team, I probably thought some of them were kind of nerdy, but once I joined the team, I saw how awesome all of them were. They just love to have fun. They're just a great group of guys and girls. Most people would probably call me a nerd for this, but I'm always on Sundays, I'm always waiting for the mileage plan to come out, just waiting to see what the workouts are. Sometimes it's pretty late at night, but I'm always waiting for them. I'm very excited, and my parents always get mad when pull my phone out at the dinner table, stop everything. This is the mileage plan for the week.
Hey. Time's
They'll come through here. They will follow this area. They're going to cut through where this team in the black is. Then they're going to go back.
I'm living in that 21st century, doing something mean to it. Do it better than anybody you ever seen. Do it, screams from the haters. Got a nice
ring
to it. 1, 2, 3, I just count the hours. Stop tripping, I'm tripping off the power. Broken, the school's closed, the prison's open. We ain't got nothing to lose. Everybody, we rolling. Everybody, we rolling. With some light skin girls and some heavy rollers. And it's white man world. We don't want to hold it. So tonight, you world, I see you in the morning. I see you in the morning. This is way too much. I need a moment. No one man should have all that power. The clock's ticking. I just count the hours. And I'm tripping off the power. Till then, that's the world's hours. Kissing nail in the whole cast. Telling me
this is what they can kiss my ass.
Napoleon, my first is Mongolian. My ice brought the goalies and I embody every characteristic of the egotistic. He knows he's so f***ing gifted. I just needed time alone with my own thoughts. Got treasures in my mind but couldn't open up my own vault. My talent, like creativity, purity and honesty is honestly being crowded by these grown thoughts. Reality is catching up with me. Taking my inner child, I'm fighting for a custody. But these responsibilities that they entrust to me. As I look down at my diamond and crush the piece, thinking no one man should have all that power. The clock's ticking, I just count the hours. Stop chipping, I'm tripping off the power. Feeling that the world's hours.
Thank you so much, all the volunteers and our athletes. And in fifth place, our very own Jack Gifford from SMCA.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh my
God. I gotta be like Nico.
For the years, it just kind of been encoded in my DNA. Like, this is what I do, this is what I love doing. There was never a specific moment. I've had many great moments over the years of like, this is why I run. You know, I'll be running a long run of my AJ and Hayden. We'll be absolutely killing ourselves, going as hard as we can, and everything just clicks. You get the runner's high, and you're like, this is why I'm here. This moment, you don't get this anywhere else.
They ain't got no muscle, no hustle, no backbone. I stand alone, not tripping. Just say I'm different. Ain't hanging on to the coattails of the next man. Passport in my left hand, thinking that you are next. Heck, oh, you ain't holding your breath, man. Cause I'm out here, I'm hungry. I don't play around, trust me. Ain't had my drive since my Honda Civic got rusty. And my girl said she loved me. It's funny, just thinking back. Study hard for that 9 to 5. Like I thought it actually be good, but that it was dreaming. Still dreaming. Spotlight on me like Willie Bean. Still performing like Al Pacino. Instagram and tuxedos with my peoples. We growing up, still don't seem like we slowing up. 10 squad, we throwing up. Every time we be showing up. Get it while I'm living. All I ever hear is the clock tick, tick, tick. So I'm about my business and I'm running. I'm running, I'm running with you now. They don't wanna give it up, we gon' make it ask. Get it while I'm living. All I ever hear is the clock tick, tick, tick. So I'm about my business and I'm running, I'm running, I'm running with you now. They don't wanna give it up, we gon' make it out. It don't get no greater, I feel like I'm
I'm on fire. Feel like I'm John Storm. Feel like I'm volatile, explosive. Get close and nothing notice. Your girl act out of character when she see me approaching and poaching. I'm just saying, it's nothing. You punching above your weight, I'm something. She ain't seen no substitute in the 18. That's BA, Baracus, that BS, that whackness. Get no play in my axis. Make them jump like AJ Hackett. Guarantee you, in these boots, they couldn't walk 1 mile. Really need to go and hang it up like a drunk doll. So behind the times, they should probably rock a sundial. Shattering their dreams, I can make their pun small. Music from the soul, don't need them to help me if they get it while I'm living. All I ever hear is the clock tick, tick, tick. So I'm got my business and I'm running, I'm running, I'm running with you now. They don't wanna give it up, we gon' make it ask. Get it while I'm living. All I ever hear is the clock tick, tick, tick. So I'm got my business and I'm running, I'm running, I'm running with you now. They don't wanna give it up, we gon' make it ask. Get it while I'm living. All I ever hear is the clock tick, tick, tick. So I'm got my business and I'm running, I'm running, I'm running with you now. They don't wanna give it up.
For the first time in SFCA history, we had three guys under 17 in one race. It was me, Jack, and Brody, and then everyone. We had a great group following right behind us, and then all the JV guys ran really well. I think Joey broke 20 for the first time, so that was huge. And then on the girls' side, they all ran very well. A lot of PRs. That was a great day. A lot of fun.
She's rocking it. We'll see how much she loves it or hates it.
This opportunity, Lord, and I pray that you would just move through us today and come expecting that you all would be
there. People dream high in the quiet of the night. You know that I caught it. Bad boy, shiny toy with a price, you know that I bought it. Killing me slow, out the window. Always waiting for you to be waiting below. Devils roll the dice, angels roll their eyes. What doesn't kill me makes me want you more.
I enjoy the consistency, maybe not in the moment, but it's nice when you're all said and done that you can look at this period of time and see that you dedicated yourself to something and you pushed through it and what you've accomplished, and that you showed up every day, even if it wasn't always your best day.
There have definitely been a couple of hurdles I've had to overcome. I think the most prominent one right now for me is my season-ending injury that I've had to somehow manage for my last senior year, which has been quite the bummer, but I've taken some very important lessons out of it. You know, I'd be doing my swimming alone in sometimes a freezing cold pool. I'm just wondering, God, why am I here right now? Like, I know you're trying to teach me something, and I need to know what it is, because I really don't enjoy this as much as I would running. And I literally felt like I was drowning with some of the freestyle I was doing at the intensity level I was. The moment I thought, I don't think I can do this alone anymore, the pool lights turned on, and it felt like that God was with me in that moment. And it was such an impactful moment for me. It taught me that I'm not alone no matter where I go, and that he's always going to have my back.
Who Steve Prefontaine is.
We do.
They don't.
How dare you?
No one, they're gonna be Googling him and think we're nerds.
Right. I don't need to say anything else other than go run for each other. Run with the talents the Lord's given you, because you guys get to do this today, and that's just so cool. You're gonna look back on days like today and be like, you're probably not even gonna remember half of the stuff you do in high school, but these are the kind of days you remember. Okay, I promise you. We're not done yet, okay? So you guys had a great performance today. Districts is a lot of mental, emotional energy. It's a lot of hype. Next week, though, we're gonna lock in and have a different kind of focus, and I think it's gonna be an exciting week as a whole, because we do it next week or we're done. So it's an exciting thing to go forward to. We get to do it, as we talk about. But overall, so proud of the top 10 finishers that we got to see take place today. That was awesome. We had PRs today. Actually, raise your hand if you PR'd today.
Yeah.
Okay, there you go. That's good stuff. So overall, I think we're ready to go for some PRs potentially next week too. And I think it's going to be an exciting week next week.
All of a sudden, I became this guy that wasn't running, but I still wanted to show that leadership role of, here's how to act if something goes wrong. This is not a time for you to be down yourself and depressed and give that to everyone else. You need to be positive. You need to be there for everybody else, and you need help in any way possible. So in our role, this is when Coach Katie was, you know, super pregnant, and she had to leave practice to go have her baby 24 hours after practice. She's crazy. And so I became what I like to call myself, the middle school coach. Took care of the middle schoolers so the two other coaches could focus on the high schoolers. and I would set up ice baths. I would get to school as early as I could and make sure the vans were packed, ready to go. I took on the support role, and I'm super happy with that. I just wanted everyone else to have an easier time and to show what serving looks like.
Be reminded that you guys are living, right? Like, this is living. Not in the sense of this is the end all, but like the fact that you get to like go out there, let your lungs burn a little bit, let your legs burn a little bit.
Yeah.
You're living, right? Like this is a powerful, I mean, really, I almost go as far to say a holy experience in the sense of when you guys put yourselves out there and do something that you're like, this would be uncomfortable. Like the Lord gets to work in ways that we don't always get to like have the say in.
And just showing people how to put in consistent hard work and get results out of my training. And I always try to talk to people about, you know, if you're going to get what you put in with this sport, that's the great thing about it is if you work hard, whether it takes a year, 2 years, 3 years, or even all of your high school career, you are going to get results if you work hard.
See if this works. 1, 2, 3. Alright, perfect. Alright, here we go. 1, 2, 3.
Look, if you had one shot, one opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted, one moment that you captured, just let it slip. Yo. His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already. Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous, but on the surface he looks calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud. He opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking how? Everybody's choking now. The clock's run out. Time's up. Back to this moment.
make this the final time.
We move toward a new world order. A normal life is boring, but superstardom's close to postmortem. It only grows harder, homie grows hotter. He blows, it's all over. These moves is all on him. Coast to coast shows, he's known as the globe trotter. Long road's got him, he knows he's grown father. From home, he's your father. He goes home and barely knows his own daughter. The Virgin knows cause he goes to cold water. He's don't want him no more, he's cold product. We moved on to the next move, he flows, he knows down the soul now. So the soul proper is told, it unfolds. I suppose it's so partner, but the beat goes on. That it up, that up, you better lose yourself in the music. The moment you hold it, you better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime. You better lose yourself in the music. The moment you hold it, you better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime. I don't want games, I'ma change what you call rage. Tear this motherfucking roof off like two dogs cage. I was playing in the beginning, the mood all changed. I've been chewed up and spit out and moved off stage. But I kept priming and step right in the next cypher. Best believe somebody's paying the Pied Piper. All the pain inside amplified by the fact that I can't get by with my 9-to-5. And I can't provide the right type of life for my family. Cause man, these damn food stamps don't buy diapers. And there's no movie, there's no Mackay Pfeiffer. This is my life and these times are so hard. And it's getting even harder trying to feed and water my seed. Plus, see this order caught up between being a father and a prima donna. Baby mama drama screaming on her too much for me to want to stay in the spot. Another damn monotony's gotten me to the point I'm like a snail. I've gotten to formulate a plot or end up in jail or shot. Success is my only motherfucking option. Failure's not. Mama love you, but this trail has got to go. I cannot go old and Salem's not. So here it comes, my shot. Feet fail me not. This may be the only opportunity I got. You better lose yourself in the music. The moment you hold it, you better never let it go. You only get one shot. Do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity goes once in a lifetime. You better lose yourself in the music. The moment you hold it, you better never let it go. You only get one shot. Do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity goes once in a lifetime. You better.
Cross country realizes what exactly they're doing. Coach Katie explains this pretty well. She says, oh, well, we have practice at 5:45, and that usually weeds out the people who want to be there to the people that don't want to be there. And so people that do come, they bring very interesting personalities that, you know, haven't been on the team before. And it's only made it better throughout the years. Like, I can't imagine the team without everyone that's on it, because they, what they bring to the table is so much different than the year prior.
The team has definitely had a huge impact on me coming out of that, my first block of summer training. I'm a completely different person. This team has really changed me for the better. It's been a great experience, and I wouldn't trade this group for the world. They've made such a lasting impact in me, and I'm always going to remember these couple seasons of them.
The biggest thing would be the relationships I built. Spend your time alone, past regrets. Most of them are my favorite people in the world, and I couldn't imagine where I would be without them. You can come to
terms and realize you're the only one. Running has impacted a lot of areas in my life. It became not only like an area that I can kind of mentally focus again, kind of like an outlet, but also it's definitely an area of my life that I like use it to rely on God and like keeps me close with Him. So it strengthened me spiritually, mentally. I feel like I would tell her a lot of my introverted self a lot of things, but I think it would just be to be present and to trust God's plan and to stick with it, because it turned out really great in the end.